affectionately known as Uncle Nate. I'm the manager of the My Brother's Keeper Greater Cleveland Chapter and Community Projects here at the Urban League of Greater Cleveland. My Brother's Keeper is an answer to the call to action that was put out. And the Urban League of Greater Cleveland answered the call. We are in 8 schools currently with 150 young men, and we'll be going to 300 young men very shortly. We get to help them with life, basically. Everything from mentoring to decision-making processes that they go through in schools. We work closely with the schools to provide them a holistic approach in matriculating through each grade. We have 9th through 12th grade young men, and in 9th and 10th grade is when we really get them exposed to opportunities. Then the 11th grade and the 12th grade is when we turn them over to our career pathways, which then has a whole nother level of exposure for them on different careers in connection with, you know, a lot of companies out here that are looking for them. So we just get to love on them. We get to help them just make it through life.
My name is Gabe Crenshaw, and I manage the Education and Career Pathways programs here at the Urban League of Greater Cleveland. Career Pathways is a program that is designed to expose our youth to in-demand industries through high engagement opportunities such as work-based learning experiences, job shadowing, and paid internships. And we do this so that students can have the opportunity to learn about different career fields and different job opportunities that they may not have been exposed to in other areas of their life.
I am Tashana Torrance, the Manager of Education and Youth Development, where we seek to equip young people with the skills, strategies, and tools to cultivate positive, holistic development. We focus on academic as well as healthy mental, emotional, and physical developmental needs of the young people we serve. We do this through the implementation of our Project Ready, which is our flagship curriculum, which is designed to increase high school retention rates and college access. We also do this through our HBCU tours, which provides young people with firsthand experience on college campuses where they get to experience firsthand the rich heritage and cultures of historically Black colleges and universities. We throughout every program and service that we provide are the keystones of social emotional development, through which we implement trauma-informed methods and approaches in engaging the youth and families we serve. We are committed to the development and implementation of equitable practices across all of our program areas and have a strong, long-standing history of success as a result of doing so. We want to be known not only for the work we do, but for the way we do the work we do.
As I look in this room, what makes me excited is this is about helping one of my favorite groups. Y'all may not get excited about it, but taking boys to men. Mm-hmm. Boys to men. Mm-hmm. Y'all feel me on that?
Okay.
So the foundations of what we're providing here for you is something. I have young men that I hear from that have been in our programs at the Urban League that are now in their 30s and 40s and call back and say, "Hey, Miss Mock, I remember when you took us here," or "I remember when you took us there," "I remember when you told us this or you told us that, and because of that thing that changed me, I didn't really understand it at that moment, but because you deposited it in us at the time when we needed it, it was there to help us through." So one of the things that Mama Maccabee does for all of her young folks is you don't get to opt out or not because you're now on my prayer list.
Okay.
So every night when I hit my knees, I have a prayer of protection for all of my family, my grandchildren, my children, you know. And now, as part of the family, you're now under that prayer of protection. So that as you come and you go and you do what you do, that you're going to start to feel an extra sense of protection. Okay. So you know Mama Maccabee is going to be praying. You know that we're going to be making decisions to help to take you from where you are right now to another level.
Nate, he is one of the best men I've ever known.
Top three.
You want to meet Nate? Promise you, meet that man. He a kind of heart.
I feel happy, excited, because we're going, and I feel more confidence in myself.
I feel excited, and I think I think my whole team did a pretty good job.
Let me tell you how I feel.
Good, I just helped somebody out. You see, I'm going to continue doing that. That's just me.
The program overall is amazing.
Ted stepped in and saved a life today.
My brother's keeper.
Tell the young man to come over here. That froze up.
Probably most people like to be in the water and the road, so we made a car boat. The solution, we made a car boat so people can stop using gas, so when the car boat get in the water, the car is going to suck the water in to make gas. Well, I say y'all.
This man is a king among the all.
Don't ever. Oh
yeah.
Youth always bring tons of energy and different perspectives to our programming. It's amazing to see how passionate they are about certain topics. Paid summer enrichment opportunities are few and far between for our targeted population. Programming like the Summer Bridge Academy can deter our youth from taking alternative pathways where the outcome could be detrimental. The youth of today are literally the change makers of tomorrow, and it's our responsibility to continue to invest and pour into their well-being.
The goal of our Summer Bridge Academy program was to provide young people with an opportunity to earn and learn, essentially. We wanted them to not only have an opportunity to earn money during the summer, earn a wage, and to be able to support their families and to be able to buy some school supplies when the summer is over, and maybe buy some new shoes and have some fun, but also to gain some skills, gain some exposure to some high demand industries, especially those within the Northeastern Ohio area. And those industries that, they can get into now or upon graduation. And we have the resources here at the Urban League to help transition them into internships and apprenticeships that can transition into jobs for them as they transition into adulthood. And so we wanted to give them access and exposure to those industries and help them to learn about it now at 14, at 15, so that when they're 17, 18, it's not such a big leap. Like, they already have the information and they already have the relationship and the resources right there at hand, and connections to community partners and local industries.
One day when the glory comes, it will be out, it will be out. Oh, one day when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh.
heavens, no man, no weapon. Formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtapositioning us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough.